Good morning. I'm Dr. Maribel Rodríguez Torres, and I am the Chief Medical Officer of Fundación de Investigación in San Juan, Puerto Rico. I would like to invite you to attend the state-of-the-art lecture that I will be presenting at the DDW this year. The topic is going to be ACV therapy. Who can wait and who cannot wait? The approval by the regulatory agencies of the first generation of protease inhibitors, telaprevir and bosaprevir, announced a new era in the treatment of chronic hepatitis C. These agents are proved to be used in combination with peginterferon and ribavirin have been shown to increase dramatically the efficacy rates both in naive and experienced patients. However, these drugs add additional side effects to the therapy of peginterferon and ribavirin. Among the significant side effects that are seen with these drugs are rash, anemia, neutropenia, and the risk for the emergence of mutations that may cause resistance to the protease inhibitor class. The triple combinations available today are only indicated for genotype 1 patients, and there is no robust efficacy or safety data in many other subpopulations of chronic hepatitis C patients. Besides patients with non-1 genotypes, there are many other subpopulations of patients that have an unmet medical need for better therapies. Among those are patients that are post-transplant, renal patients co-infected with HIV, the null responders, and the cirrhotic patients. In this state-of-the-art lecture, we will discuss a paradigm to differentiate patients that have the best opportunity to achieve cure or SVR with the available therapies from the patients that have a reduced benefit with available therapies and should do better waiting for the new wave of drugs to be approved and be available. We hope that you will attend this lecture as the information that we'll be discussing will be helpful to you to better treat your chronic hepatitis C patients. Thank you.